Wild World of Real Estate. Rooftop edition, starting off in Bangalore, India, where Indian politician and businessman Viraj Mallya just built a White House replica on the top of a skyscraper. That's right, it's at the Kingfisher Tower, and this White House replica is going to be 40,000 square feet. That's right, it's gonna have an indoor heated pool with an outdoor infinity pool. It's gonna have a helipad so he can land his chopper, a gym, a spa, a salon, and a wine cellar because rich people love wine. This construction is about halfway done and it is halted. That's right. Unfortunately, Mr. Mallya was doing some money laundering and was not paying back his loans. So he has fled the country to the United Kingdom. So now the Indian government is stuck holding the bag. They're trying to figure out how to pay back all of his bad loans and get him back into the country. To be continued. Next, a little bit more of a feel-good story here as we head to Copenhagen, Denmark, where they have built a ski slope on the top of a power plant. That's right, folks, it's called Copenhill. And this isn't just any old ordinary power plant. It is the cleanest waste to energy power plant in the world, converting 440,000 tons of waste to energy every single year. This power plant single-handedly powers 150,000 homes. Good on you, Denmark. And Copenhagen is actually a city that is committed to being the first carbon neutral city by 2025. Now the ski slope is 400 meters. For you Americans, that's a quarter mile. It has open year round, has a 180 degree turn, as you can see from the photos, which kind of scares me because my skiing style is straight at 80 miles an hour. So I'm not sure if I can make that turn, but I'm not a huge skier. The machinery inside the power plant is put in by height so they can make the slope, which is very cool. It even has a half mile walking trail with a beautiful garden. There's a rooftop bar here, and it has the tallest artificial climbing wall as well. Good on you, Denmark. It'd be cool to see more cities follow your lead. And finally, we're heading to Montreal in Canada, where IGA Grocery Store is taking green to the next level. That level, the rooftop. It's a 25,000 square foot rooftop garden where they make all their own produce. This is incredible. Up to 35 different types, everything you could want. Kale, spinach, garlic, carrots, the works. They even have a section on the roof where they have their own beehives where they make their own honey. Now this grocery store is taking things to the next level, and there's a lot of benefits to this program. First of all, having a rooftop garden helps regulate the store's energy, so they save there. They're not transporting the goods, so they're saving on all the environmental aspects of transportation. And here's one of the coolest aspects of this garden. So those plants need to be watered, right? So they have an irrigation system. The water for the irrigation system is actually taken from the store's dehumidification system. That water is typically thrown out in other residences, but instead they recycle it and use it to power the plants. It's incredible. I wish more people would jump on this bandwagon. We'll see if it happens. Nice little touch as well as they form the crops to have IGA on the rooftop. If you get a chance to see that, obviously the pictures show that as well. Wild World of Real Estate. This is Rooftop Edition. If you liked it, subscribe, like, be kind.